Okay, so recently Anthropic has been on a roll, not only with the launch of their Claude 3.5 Sonnet model, which now everybody is saying is the best model out there, but they also had a lot of success with things like the artifacts that I covered in a previous video. And then since then, they've gone on to also have the whole sort of Claude projects, a way to manage prompts and docs and stuff like that in there. But up until now, all of these have been focused on the consumer user interface with that. Of course, the Sonnet model has been available on the API as well, but most of the user interface stuff has been aimed at the sort of consumer area. That is until now. So yesterday, Anthropic announced that they've basically updated their whole workbench area for developers. So this is in the Anthropic console. And what this basically allows you to do is do a bunch of new things with the console that allows you to generate prompts from scratch. And then, more importantly than that, allows you to actually test out those prompts and get a sense of like where that prompt is strong, perhaps where that prompt is weak. And you end up creating a whole test suite that you can then use to basically benchmark a whole bunch of different things about your prompt and about the response and how it's using the context and all of those things as it goes through this. So then you can fine tune your prompt even more to get you better results out of this. So this really is a game changer in many ways for developers being able to get the best prompts for their particular applications, whether that be for summarizing a document, whether that be for handling customer queries, that kind of thing. It allows you then to basically generate a prompt out and will get you good results of that. So let's jump in and have a look at just how this actually works. Okay, so you can see that I've come in here, I've basically set up and described the task in here. So the task I'm going to give it is draft a response to a YouTube comment that can classify which comments are toxic and which deserve a reply in here. So you can see I just start out with something very simple like this, and then just by pressing generate prompt, Claude will actually go in and write out a full prompt that goes for this. You can see this is quite a long prompt that it's generated out here. So here we can see we've got like setting the context or the sort of system message in here. You are an assistant tasked with analyzing YouTube comments to determine if they are toxic and whether they deserve a reply. Your goal is to help manage community engagement. So it's filled in a lot of things that I didn't say. Now you can see also it's basically put it so we can put the comment in here. And then it's got the step-by-step analysis of this. So one of the really interesting things with Anthropic is they kind of have their own version of chain of thought in there. So this is referred to in their prompts as ant thinking, right? I think the ant stands for Anthropic. And often in the consumer-facing products, that is actually never shown to the end user, or often not shown to the end user. But we can see here that they're getting at some of that in here, of basically carefully reading, consider the content and tone of the comment, determine if the comment is toxic, consider factors such as use of offensive language, personal attacks, hate speech, threats of harassment, excessive negativity or trolling. And you can see that it's going through, decide if the comment deserves a reply, provide your analysis, and then it's got some analysis, so it's going to basically give us out an analysis of toxicity, reply worthy, classification. All right, so let me try that out. And now I can just select continue if I'm happy with that. And you see, this now brings me to the workbench where I can actually title this as YT. And you can see that I could actually take this and I could put this in the system prompt. I can, you know, do something like this. But what I want to do is, okay, I've got this prompt here. And when I go to run it, it automatically wants me to fill in what the YouTube comment is. All right, so here's the comment. This video was useful, but a bit long. Definitely, you know, I could say that about some of my videos. Okay, so when we run it, we can see that the response back, that it comes back that, okay, it's not toxic, and then it goes through why, and then this comment deserves a reply. And then it gives us a sort of final classification in there. Now, if I come over here and go to evaluate, so we've done that just for one. If I want to generate a bunch of these sort of test cases, I can just come down here and click generate. And you'll see that, sure enough, it's now going to generate another test case in there. And we can see that, okay, this one, you know, is, we can see that the one it's generated is probably a bit more negative. But let's see when we run it. And you can see that, okay, it's got the idea of moderate toxicity in there. It's done that. If I want to, I can basically come in here and edit anything in the actual prompt itself. I go back to my evaluate, and you see that what I'm doing here is I'm building sort of a library of various evaluations. And notice that it's versioning the actual prompt, it's versioning the responses. And if I want to, I could go through and upload a bunch of these, so I can manually just add some in here. I can import a bunch of test cases from a CSV file or something like that. Okay, so what I've done now is I've made a second attempt at this where I've just changed some of the things in it slightly. And if I want to see, okay, how well does this do, I can now basically run the first prompt against the second one. And I could actually do versioning of these as well. So I could have like versions of these as well. So this allows me to compare this. And then once those are done, I can come along and score these. So I can say, okay, this one, yeah, that was excellent. This one was very good. This one was excellent. Let's say I put this one as fair. This one is fair. And you're going to see that they're probably very similar because all I did was move something from the user part to the system part in here. And you can see that it's automatically now scoring each prompt. So I can use this to basically do my evaluation in here. So from this, I can basically do all my evaluation of which prompt worked out better, that kind of thing. It will be very interesting if you test on different models and stuff as well going forward, if you could compare the haiku response to the sonnet response and stuff like that. But anyway, in the past, this is the kind of thing that you would often do and put in a spreadsheet and get people to score it, using something like MOS or mean opinion scoring to get different people to score it and work out, okay, which prompt most people thought was doing well or not, kind of thing. The cool thing is now this is all in here. You can actually do all of this. And then when you're done, you can just come up here and click the code and you basically get the code for actually running this with your prompt set up, with everything set up in there. Now, you may want to change the maximum number of tokens or some things like that. Now, if you want to actually run this against a different model, you could come through and run it against, say, the haiku model and that in here as well. So overall, this gives you a way of basically generating prompts with that initial sort of generation, and then a way to check those prompts, edit those prompts, and then benchmark those prompts or evaluate those prompts so that you can actually see the results out all in this dashboard that you can then basically use to export your code and put it into trial or into production in here. Overall, very cool, useful feature. You should definitely check it out if you're using the Anthropic models, and you probably should be using Anthropic models at the moment, or at least be trying them out when they're doing so well on so many different things in here. Anyway, so as always, if you've got any questions or comments, put them in the comments below. I don't know if I'll be running this on all the comments in there, but it's certainly something that we could look at doing. If you've got any questions or anything, put them in there as well. If you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.